One Easter Sunday, the children's teacher surprised the class by spilling a box of Legg's pantyhose eggs on the table in front of them. Remember those? The following instruction was given. Children, take an egg, go outside this beautiful spring day, find some symbol for new life, and put it in the Legg egg. When we come back into the classroom, we'll share our symbols of new life, and we'll open the containers one by one. We'll all be surprised by what you find. After running around the church property in wild confusion, the students returned to their classroom and placed their Legg eggs in a box on the table. Surrounded by the children, the teacher began to open them one by one. And after each one, whether it was a flower, a butterfly, or a leaf, the class would ooh and ah at what they represented. Then one was opened and revealed there was nothing inside. And the children began to exclaim, "That's stupid! That's not fair! Somebody didn't do their assignment." One little boy spoke up, "Hey, that's mine." "Well, Philip, you don't ever do things right. You never do things right. There's nothing there." "I did so do it," Philip insisted. "I did do it right. It's empty because the tomb was empty." Maybe that's an Easter lesson that we overlook. Kind of like the women that made their way to the tomb on that first Easter. See, we celebrate Easter not for what is there, but for what is not there. The angel said, "He's not here. He is risen." So for the Christ follower, we celebrate that new reality. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? Grave, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who does give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So what do we say now? He did his assignment. He did it. It's empty. The tomb is empty. Just a thought.